Welcome to our podcast that's been named one of the best in marketing research. This is Research Business Daily Report, the industry's only daily research video report. And we're made possible by the exclusive community at our crowdfunding platform, patreon.com/RBDR. I'm Bob Lederer, for more than 25 years, a respected voice in market research. Personalization is every marketer's deepest aspiration. However, that goal is so relatively new, and the relevant required technology is still so primitive, or in many instances unproven, that one can almost very quickly pinpoint the fields and companies where it has been applied and worked. Apparently, to discover where personalization has made its biggest recognizable dent, the place to look is the quick service restaurant field. That, according to Associate Editor Chris Kelly, who last week authored a feature on Marketing Dive about how QSRs are showing the way on personalized experiences. Kelly referred to a handful of potential personalization paths that QSR companies have pursued. However, there is a reality that only one element seems to be the distinguishing personalization characteristic. Growing numbers of brick-and-mortar operations believe technology is the essential component offering strategic advantage. Showing the way so far in the personalization game in QSRs is market giant McDonald's. It lapped the rest of the field by spending $300 million to acquire Dynamic Yield last year. That's a business which has been helping brands create what is called, quote, an Amazon-style personalized online experience, end of quote. RBDR reported in depth about that McDonald's buyout back on April 8th of last year, and if you're interested, we've linked to that report. It's in the description box underneath today's video. Another big personalization QSR player apparently is Starbucks, which entered a partnership and investment in Brightloom. That company designed standalone consumer engagement platforms. Apparently, the Starbucks idea is for customers to order via kiosk, thereby eliminating employee interaction and presumably amassing a ton of collected personal preference data. Dennis Becker, chairman and CEO of mobile marketing provider Mobivity, is not someone who is as technology obsessed as others seem to be. He told Kelly that consumers, quote, need to be reached in a myriad of ways because the purchase decision is moment by moment. And may I add, it's also without a break during the course of most days, as consumers at any given time seek out food or a drink. So Becker's type of personalization is exemplified by Burger King applying dynamic creative to drive daypart consumer decisions. And then there's Dunkin', which unleashed AI bots to drive treat traffic during National Donut Day. The big picture from Kelly seems to be that QSRs need to close the widening gap between consumer demands and the reality of what marketers are actually capable of delivering. And he said that some QSRs have concluded that hiring third parties to deliver personalization solutions may be a lot less effective than acquiring those organizations. Dennis Becker commented, quote, if brands take their own media and one-to-one channels where they have greater control, they can move optimization of market budgets much faster than if they continuously are at the mercy of third-party intermediaries. In short, more and better in-house technology has a bigger payout. In time, companies may perceive backfilling several imperative operational areas with technology not only as something they like, but as an act of survival. That's your Research Business Daily Report, made possible by our exclusive community at the crowdfunding platform, patreon.com/RBDR. We hope that you and all other RBDR viewers appreciate our reports, even share them with peers and friends. That may lend an understanding of why it makes sense to support us, as do many viewers who we refer to as our Patreon supporters. And we're happy today to welcome Kathy Allen and Decision Insight as our latest Patreon supporter. Thank you. We know that the 5-minute average video length for an RBDR is perceived by viewers as time well spent, or frankly, why would they even bother watching day after day as they do? RBDR viewers share our videos with business associates and their customers, And that's just another piece of evidence about the value of what you're watching right now. In fact, I can tell you that sharing an RBDR video with any client, if you compliment it with a message that says this particular video brought them to mind, well, it's going to elicit a very positive reaction from the client. So you're invited to support RBDR by visiting patreon.com/RBDR yourself. And in no more than perhaps a minute, you can join us as an RBDR sponsor. Thank you in advance. Have a great research day, and we'll see you back here with us tomorrow.